divine orchestration. Nehemiah chapter 2, verses 4 to 8. Then the king said to me, "What do you request?" So I prayed to the God of heaven. And I said to the king, "If it pleases the king, and if your servant has found favor in your sight, I ask that you may send me to Judah, to the city of my father's tombs, that I may rebuild it." Then the king said to me, the queen also sitting beside him, "How long will your journey be, and when will you return?" So it pleased the king to send me, and I set him a time. Furthermore, I said to the king, "If it pleases the king, let letters be given to me for the governors of the region beyond the river, that they must permit me to pass through till I come to Judah. And a letter to Asaph, the keeper of the king's forest, that he must give me timber to make beams for the gates of the citadel, which pertains to the temple, for the city wall, and for the house that I will occupy." And the king granted them to me according to the good hand of my God upon me. As we continue in the book of Nehemiah, we see God orchestrating things in Nehemiah's life. To begin with, Nehemiah was a royal cupbearer, a very important and a privileged position that he had to serve the king of Persia. Imagine him being day in and day out, just right beside the king, serving him. He was probably the closest to the king of Persia besides the queen herself. And so this was a very privileged position that Nehemiah had. Now, as Nehemiah's heart was stirred about rebuilding the walls of the city of Jerusalem, and as he had been spending the last 4 months praying about it, suddenly a day came when he had the opportunity to present his burden, the burden of his heart, to the king. He asked the king permission to be able to go back to Judah, to the city of Jerusalem, and to carry out this assignment. The king granted him leave. He granted him permission to do that. And then he extended other requests. He wanted a safe journey to Jerusalem. He requested for the provision, the things that he needed to rebuild the walls of the city. And all of these things were divinely granted for Nehemiah. And Nehemiah realized it was because of the good hand of God upon him, meaning God was in this. God was orchestrating those things that he had asked, the whole thing that he had asked for. God's hand was upon him. So here's a very important lesson that we must understand, that where there is a God-given assignment, God's hand will be on you to orchestrate things for you so that you can move into fulfilling that assignment. Have confidence in the good hand of God upon you. When God is backing you up, no man and no devil can stop it. When God has assigned you to fulfill something on the earth, he will set people, places, and things in their right, bringing them together at the right time so that you can go about fulfilling that assignment. Believe that God will divinely orchestrate things for you as you walk with him into the purposes he has for your life. Let's pray together. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the amazing lesson we see here in Nehemiah, how he orchestrated things in his life so that he could actually move in to fulfilling that burden that he was carrying in his heart, which you had put there, Lord. And so, Father, we pray for our own selves, that as we recognize your purposes for our lives, as we set out to do those things, we pray that you will divinely orchestrate things for us. Bring in the divine provision, bring in the people, bring in the resources, open up the doors, set things in motion so that we too can fulfill what you assigned for our lives in our day, in our time. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.